really want to thank y'all for coming today, and I want to mention again that none of the information that you guys gone out until tonight, we wanted to give y'all a start, just to thank you for coming down. The meeting has been wonderful in covering this subject and transportation subjects in general in Georgia. So thank you so much. Our purpose today is to present these 500, actually it's supposed to be 400, but it's closer to 5, petitions to Governor Deal today, requesting the removal of the Georgia 400 toll. But before we do that, I wanted to explain just a little bit of background and give you the current financial status as to why this toll can be removed and how we can do it. I want to start with these two documents. This is the original City of Atlanta Ordinance from 1989 that was signed for the construction of Georgia 400. And this is the agreement from the Georgia Department of Transportation adhering to the Atlanta City Ordinance. I'm just going to read you one paragraph out of this, which I think is important. It states that all tolls shall be discontinued upon full payment of all bonds which are issued to finance construction of the Georgia 400 extension and the Buckhead Loop. Now, there's two important points in this city ordinance, which has never been overridden by any state law. One is that the money must be funded only for the Buckhead Loop and the Georgia 400 extension. This is inside of 285. No money was supposed to be spent anywhere else according to this agreement. In addition, when that money, construction costs were completely repaid, the toll was required to be moved by Atlanta City Ordinance and by approval of the Georgia Department of Transportation. So that, we believe, is the legal and ethical reason why this toll needs to be removed. The toll was repaid. The bond, this was funded by a $96 million bond, $100 million of federal highway funds, and also millions of dollars of local, state and local funds. But the bond was retired or was repaid in 2009. Enough money was collected to pay off the bond in 2009. CERTA continued to collect money, another $40 million up until 2011 when the bond actually retired. And it was matured at that time. So in 2011, there was a $42.5 million surplus of taxpayer funds. In spite of that, by the way, I need to also mention to you one other thing that's important. In addition to the surplus funds, in 2002, Governor Bonds bought a $10 million piece of property on 17th Street with this toll money. And that has nothing to do with the actual Georgia 400 toll either. So in 2010, as most of you know, Governor Perdue convinced the board to extend this toll. And he issued a new $40 million bond, allegedly for the purpose of building the Buckhead Interchange. But the Buckhead Interchange only came in a bid of it, $21.5 million. So a $40 million bond was issued for a $21 million project. And at that point in time, CERTA had roughly $50 million in cash, assets, and future receivables that were going to come in until the bond expired. So at that stage, there was no reason to issue a bond whatsoever. CERTA was cash rich. Nevertheless, that bond was issued and the toll was extended. And we believe that toll was extended in order, according to state law, it had to be extended in order. They had to have a bond in order to extend the toll. That was the real purpose. So where are we now? Just before the bond was issued, Governor Nathan Deal made a pledge to tear down this toll. That was during the campaign when he was running for in the Republican primary in June of 2002. He now says that his hands are tied by this bond that was created in 2010, and this is our point of contention. We do not believe that to be true whatsoever. If I can find them, I would like to read some of Nathan Deal's own comments from June 2010. Nathan Deal said, "As governor, I will swing the sledgehammer to bring down the Buckhead Wall. The state has collected more than enough money to pay the bonds for the highway. We are now using the tolls of Georgia 400 drivers to pay for other road projects. That is not fair to the commuters." Now, that is exactly what is being done today. The bond money and the money insert is being used for 10 special pet projects that were initiated as a result of Senate Purdue's action in September of 2010. Governor Deal went on to say, "Closing the Georgia 400 tolls keeps the promise made to Georgians when it originally opened. Not only will it eliminate costs for Georgia drivers, but it will open up a bottleneck in one of Atlanta's most congested areas by allowing traffic to flow freely." Now, I truly believe that truer words have never been spoken about the Georgia 400 toll than what Nathan Deal spoke on June 22 of 2010. I would commend him for that. But now, the governor is saying that he cannot do anything, and again, there's two excuses that we're hearing that I'd like to address today. Number one is that he has no power. Governor Deal is chairman of the sort of board, the five-member board, which is actually the same board that voted to extend the toll under Governor Purdue. So he could easily tell the board to remove the toll if he wanted to. I'm sure we believe that the board would overwhelmingly support his action. Finally, it's the question of funds, and this is where we really want to get to. Do we have the funds to remove the toll today? Yes, we do, because according to CERTA's own records, they have almost $70 million in cash. $70 million, approximately $68 million last count. The money needed to build the Buckhead Interchange ramps, which are the I-85 south to Georgia 400 north and vice versa, those new ramps, is according to their numbers, which we are somewhat disputing, but is $29 million. But using their numbers, $29 million, and then another $33 million to retire the bond that was taken out in 2010, and pay all of the interest to the bondholders all the way until the maturity date of 2017. So the bond can be totally repaid, the interest on the bond can be repaid for the next 5 years, and the Buckhead Interchange can be finished, and they would still have $500 million bucks left over to tear down the toll. So that is where we stand today financially. We simply ask, there's only one decision that has to be made by the governor, and that is to suspend Sunny Purdue's pet projects until they can be funded normally through normal transportation means. Those projects have nothing to do with the Georgia 400 extension, and they're in violation of the agreement with the City of Atlanta and the GDOT that GDOT also signed. So to continue this imposes a $100 million tax burden on the residents and the motorists of Fulton County and Atlanta who use this Buckhead Georgia 400 extension. And it is unfair to take the money from these people and route it to all these pet projects that may be 25 miles or more away and may have nothing to do So with that, before we present the petitions to the governor, we're going to open it up for questions. I'm sure you all probably have a lot of questions and plans to answer anything that you have. Nobody has any questions?
Have you spoken with anyone from the governor's office about whether or not this is feasible?
Well, we have not spoken as to whether or not it's feasible. And we know that it is feasible, and the governor's office and the spokesperson saying that it's not. What they are saying is that it would be an abrogation of the contract, that it would damage the bond rating of the state. And what we're saying, that assumes that you're not going to pay the interest on the bond. What we're saying is, CERTA already has the money to pay the bondholders in full in the interest, and they could set up a trust fund, or CERTA, which does bond management, could arrange to pay off the bond so that there's no obligation whatsoever that's unfulfilled to the bondholders.
So, where is the call to action here? Who are you saying needs to act on this now?
It's simply a matter, what we see is a couple-step process. One is the governor of the state of Georgia has to make a personal decision that this was the wrong thing to do. And he has to correct the wrong that was done by Governor Sonnenfeld. Once he does that, he simply can tell the board, the CERTA board, he thinks the toll should be removed. We are convinced that the CERTA board would agree to remove the toll if he wants to opt. And the reason we're convinced of that is because his policy and budget director is on there. A gentleman who already voted against the toll was on the board, and two other members who have never voted to extend the toll are also on the board. So essentially, Republicans are controlling 4 out of 5 board slots, and there's one independent. It's just a simple matter of them deciding that they want it off, and it'll be gone.
What is your plan now? Are you presenting this to the governor and then just hoping that he replies? Like, what's the next step?
So what's the next step? What we feel like we need to do is to give the governor a little bit of time to digest this material, and hopefully he will come to the right decision on his own accord without any further action being taken. So our plan right now is to let the governor chew on this for a couple of weeks, and hopefully he'll come to the right decision on his own. We will also probably be raising this more with the mayor of Atlanta. I raised it with Atlanta City Council. I'm fascinated by the city of Atlanta is not attempting to enforce its own agreement, and we're down here as citizens trying to enforce their agreement when it's their $100 million as much as it is ours.
So just to clarify, have you made any contact with the governor's office? Have you heard from the governor's office about this yet?
We have not. This is our first official communication. We wanted to get all the facts together now so that we could present our case. And as we requested an electronic reply this time, we have heard the comments emanating from this press spokesman, which we believe to be incorrect, in fact, flat out false. So what we're going to do is to give the government a chance to respond to what we have, and hopefully we'll get a little bit better.
Do you believe it's as simple as the governor saying, let's do this, and then the CERTA board would have to do it?
It was about that simple to get the toll extended in violation of the Atlanta City ordinance. So it ought to be that simple to get it removed. Now, the reason why we do think that it's that simple is because these $30 million of pet projects have not been let out for contract. They're simply memos of understanding with the Department of Transportation, and therefore they could simply agree to suspend that effort until we can get the funds from normal way of transportation projects are funded in Georgia.
Are you hoping today, at the point of this press conference, to draw more light to the fact? Do you think that most people aren't aware of the governor's previous promises and the fact that this has already been paid for?
Well, yes, there is, you're right, there needs to be more awareness. And really, I want to thank the media, because y'all have done a fantastic job of raising the awareness of this issue. I've never seen such an issue covered so well in the press, and I've been dealing with the press for quite a few years. So yes, the intent is to raise the awareness. Most people know that the road has been paid for, but what they don't know is that the agreement required that all money be spent on the Georgia Foreign Extension, which is inside of the 285. And they're not aware of the illegality of routing that money out into other districts, which quite frankly are largely Republican
Why bring this up now as opposed to 2 years ago?
Yeah, great question, Matt. So why are we bringing this up now? I don't think that any of us believed that what happened in 2010 would have actually happened, that the toll would be extended in violation of the agreement. The other thing is that we as the activists in September of 22 were all wrapped up in campaigns and election type work, like many of us are now. So we did not dedicate at the time that we should have to address this right in the beginning. Now the other thing is that we thought that these surplus funds that were collected through 2011 were going to be used for the Buckhead Interchange and also for the I-85 access programs. If you are familiar, there's no way to connect Georgia 400 with the Spring and West Peachtree corridors for phone traffic in and out of town. So what we thought was going to happen is that set of funds, that $42 million collected between 2009 and 2011, would be dedicated to those projects. And that might have been a worthwhile expenditure because it's in accordance with the agreement that they had with the city of Georgia and GTA. So we were kind of caught by surprise. And now we feel like after we've seen the figures, we're just in awe of what was done in 2010.
Sorry.
Yeah, the first name is Garland, G-A-R-L-A-N-D, and my last name is Favorito, F-A-V-O-R-I-T-O. And I want to recognize some of the folks standing behind me. These are quite a few of the leaders in Fulton and our surrounding counties, and they have been instrumental in putting all this together. They didn't want to speak today, but we couldn't have done it without all the tremendous help we're getting from a variety of sources, particularly around in the Fulton area. So if there's no other questions, is there any other questions before we wrap up? Okay, well, we're gonna walk these petitions into the governor's office. We're not expecting to be there, but it's about to walk. Thank you very much for coming. Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yes, if anybody would like to videotape the petitions and the letter, we'll put all this out for you to videotape. Would you like me to just lay it out?
I was
going to
say,
yeah.
Yeah, let me, how about if
you want me to just sit down?
Yeah, just
put them
on the steps.
Is that okay?
Just put them on the steps.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll put the letter out every day you're going to get it.
Ladies.
now have enough money to remove the tar, and the governor has the power to do that, so we're asking him if he will honor his 2010 pledge to remove that and consider how to do that. We've explained in the letter. This is the letter to the governor that will explain what we found and why we believe that he can do it. And we think it would be a tremendous thing for all of Georgia to see when that toll booth comes down as he promised to do it today. Thank you very much.
Focused on the growth and development of African-American business owners here in metropolitan Atlanta. So we are here this morning to make sure that our membership and our voices are heard. And to that extent, we've called together this press release and a group of leaders that will speak this morning about our position as it relates to the TIA.
Please join me in welcoming our mayor, phenomenal leader, Mayor Kasim Reed. Thank each and every one of you for being here. You all, this is important. This is important. Everybody, when you all leave here, I want you all to take the rest of the day off after 5 o'clock if you're sitting there. And I want y'all to wake up tomorrow. I want y'all to wake up tomorrow. Because we're going to win this thing.
Yes, sir.
We're going to win this thing. We're going to win this thing. Are there any questions from the press? We made our point.
Mayor Reed, I would like to know why. Yeah.
I would like to know why the city of Atlanta is not enforcing this agreement with the state of Georgia to remove the Georgia Department tolls, because the road has already been paid for, and $100 million of money
is being extracted out of the city of Atlanta?
No, I haven't. I want to answer. No, I don't duck. I'm right here. The city is not enforcing an agreement because the Georgia General Assembly changed the law. You don't need to hand me a document, sir. I know what the agreement is, and I've read it. Now, I respected your space, you respect mine. The city is not enforcing an agreement because the state law was changed. And the leadership at the Georgia General Assembly made the decision to extend the toll and did so in a public fashion by vote of the General Assembly. Now, I will also state that the revenue from the extension of the Georgia 400 toll is being used to enhance traffic in the community of Buckhead and to build exits in the community of Buckhead. So one out of two of the new dollars that are being generated by the Georgia 400 toll are going into the city of Atlanta for traffic improvement in the community of Buckhead. That's why the toll was extended, and it was done under Governor Perdue. Anybody else? All right. Thank you, everybody.
Please turn out and vote. Take your friends, your family. Take mom and them and all of them out. Let's vote on the 31st.
This is about global economics. This is our city. These are employees and all the guests of our city who can't even move around this city. This is not about market. And don't even think about getting back to the table. You'll get back to the table 5 years from now. You know, and all of this will be done. You know, huh? Okay. I can't change your vote, but I can try.
Oh, sure. Hey.
Because, I come from the city of Chicago, and I watch Mayor Daley do the Dan Ryan when I was a little kid. And now you can't do that. At that time, that window's closed. If you don't do this now, it doesn't get done. And we shut the world out. It's like in football, it's called a stiff arm, saying don't come to me. You know, we absolutely got to have it. Absolutely.
Okay, sir.
All right. God bless you.
No.
We're going to keep saying no.